Is it working? Hello. Do you want to have a look at my pigments?
Yes.
I'm all the time very excited about the colors when I see this kind of buffet. That makes me happy. I think this is very cool to just get inspired by the colors, yeah. It's just very, very cool. This is my color buffet here, and I really like that because it's so inspiring. I mean, I have more colors, but I think this is just enough to show. And look at that, isn't that gorgeous? It's like salmon, I think you say. It reminds me of a coat from a king. And here are the green colors, the green pigments I use for all my green paintings. This is, for example, a certain kind of pastry with the pigments, and I change. Sometimes I use this to have a more thicker layer of color, and then I use the more fluid and liquid color. So how do you call that?
Spatula.
What?
Spatula.
A spatula. A big one. A big spatula. The idea actually to paint green mixed media paintings stems or is because my gallerist Matt Frog, you have sent me those photos for Moorgate, an English or a wall, a castle wall in Great Britain, and and you've sent me close-ups of the wall, yeah? And with a lot of texture in it, and with rust and gray stone and green moss, very rough and good photos. So actually I got inspired by it and thought, well, I should try to paint in green. Like about the pastry as well is that you, for example, can do scratches. Or when you go outside and go in nature, And you are surrounded by green, but the green is never flat, it's alive. And this is because there is a lot of light with it, or shadows and different kind of greens. And I wanted to transport that on my paintings. And so there's one layer of pigments over the other. So you really have you get a depth in the painting, yeah? That you have the feeling that there is something behind, or yeah, that there's room in the painting. And that's it. One layer done. When I start a painting, and this is supposed to be a green one as well, and there's already a black ground. I painted it black with black color, and then here is a layer with ash, and ash gives a lot of texture to the painting right from the front. And now I'm going to put again a black layer of pigments, of watery pigments. I'm going to pour it over the painting. Already. It's very watery. It's just like black pigments with water and the glue. So. About the brown, you don't see that anymore, and you hardly see anything of the black, but the texture of the ash is still there, and it's important for the painting. And to make it more dramatic, we can even add add some gray stone. It's called, in Germany it's called Schiefer. It's like an earth pigment. I don't know how the English...
Green earth, it looks like to me.
I don't know the English translation.
I think it's called green earth.
No, it's green earth? Mm-hmm. No, it's not green earth, it's like a gray stone. Okay. It's a stone flower. And you can just
proprietary secrets. Will it maintain its color when it's dry, this color? Will it remain grayish white?
Yeah. Underneath, so it's not going to the sits in the middle of the water.
Mm-hmm.
Whether
so it runs, it keeps running.
So I'm going to leave it this and this way, and when it's dry, I'm going to have to look what the painting needs next. What kind of color what kind of color of pigments. If it's going to be another gray or black or green, we'll see.
Thank you.